So tonight, the team have come to St Wilfrid's Church in Hickleton. This is a place that myself and Danny have investigated before. We had all kinds of activity, you know, we had the voice of a child, we had the footsteps, we were told to turn around and face something, we had orbs, we had everything going off here, didn't we? Danny's wife did a lone vigil and she had things happen that she could not explain, she was totally sceptic. This place was built in 1150 AD, but archaeologists date this actual land back a lot further than that, and there's always believed to have been a church on this very ground since Anglo-Saxon times. But yeah, Steve's here tonight, Emma's on camera, and we've also got Heidi Cooke, a local medium, so they don't want to know anything about this location at all, so it's going to be interesting to see if they can cross paths tonight and come up with the same sort of things. So without further ado, let's get this investigation underway. So guys at home, what you're actually looking at here is two real human skulls. Now, this is a real skull, this is a real skull, and the one in the middle is actually a replica. The reason why there's a replica is because some time ago, some absolute nutcase decided that they wanted a real human skull. Now, there is an inscription in Latin above, but below it translates to English, and it says, "Today for me, tomorrow for thee," which is basically a sign really that we're all going to end up this way one day. These skulls are believed to have been local highwaymen, and they were hung locally. It's believed that these skulls were fetched here and put on display as a sign and a warning to others not to commit crimes. Other ghost stories from this area include an headless horseman that's said to ride up and down the main road, and it's been seen on numerous occasions. Now, we're about to get this investigation underway. We're going to meet up with Steve and Heidi, and we're going to crack on and see what we get.
I was going to say, Heidi's just said she's just feeling like she just wants to laugh.
And what's that from? Just like, just a happy feeling, or?
Yeah, that's all.
Sounds like you, Danny, doesn't it?
I know.
So we've been drawn over to this cross.
Yeah, we were just saying, as we were walking, Heidi just started giggling. She says, "I just feel like I just want to laugh." So I just feel really giggly.
Just as we're walking up here, obviously don't say no names on there, but I was picking up on name Robert, and I feel that's a connection with why I've got to go around here.
Robert, yeah.
So we'll see.
Right, so what do we do from here then? Do you want to break out some equipment, or shall we just start calling out first as usual?
Yeah. Start calling out first, and then see what we get after.
Yeah.
With equipment.
We normally start with that, don't we?
Yeah. So if there's any spirits around tonight that would like to communicate with us, please do step forward. We have two people here that can connect with you spiritually, so you'll be able to pass messages to them. If you've got a story to tell, you'll be able to tell these, and we'll all be able to hear it. So please do step around.
You might remember myself and Danny from before. You might also remember Heidi. If the little girl's here that was running around myself and Danny before, could you come round and do that again? Let us know that you're here. We told you we'd come back.
Did you hear that?
Straight away over there.
Straight away, yeah. What? That was like leaves, but there is around driving past, and but that was pretty
good.
There.
I did.
Somebody was just peeking around that door.
Around that door. That's where Farah sat before and cheered all them footsteps. Do you want to?
Just, do you want to go move over there?
Yeah, please.
Yeah.
So we're going to the place where Farah did her lone vigil, and she was hearing those unexplained footsteps. Heidi's just said that she's seen someone peeking round the door.
What was that? Did someone just hear a noise as well? So we got here, it went, wah. But that could be animals, but
I can hear someone here.
Yeah. Are you playing games with us again?
What? So it's to make him jump then, I don't even know why.
You've got a mischievous head on, haven't you?
I'm really giggly.
Ever, she's been giggling ever since she walked in.
Yeah.
Do you know why
you? I just wanted to go into a boom.
It's a good sign, though, isn't it?
Yeah. Like I said, we did.
Was someone, and I know it was a lad, and I'd say he was about 14, if that, and he was peeping around all that.
Do you feel what era he might have been from, I would say?
So he's telling me 17, but I don't know if that were his age.
Okay.
I'm rubbish with ages, I'm rubbish with names.
Okay.
But that's the age he looked to me. He looked about 14, but he's telling me 17.
Okay.
But he's also telling me James and Bill and William.
Bill? How many times have we had Bill before?
Really?
I wonder if it's the same guy. That's since we've been here, isn't it?
Yeah.
Billy. Bill.
Any of them names that Heidi's just mentioned, can you come forward and let us know that you're here and give us a sign? Make us jump if you want to play a few games, that's fine. You see, I can't connect, so I would like to feel your presence.
Could you make a really distinctive sound for us, just to try and alert us to your presence?
Yeah, you are.
I'm fine.
Bless you. It's gone.
She had to say that message. Yeah, she had to say what she had to say there.
What's up, Danny?
I've got that 17 that you've brought up. It's playing over in my head. I'm trying to think what it is. It's linking in somewhere here.
That Bible, pages 17.
Oh, yeah.
Your Bible.
Yeah.
That just come in my head.
Not that.
I'm just thinking Bible, church.
Oh. No, that'll be.
Well, this kid thought that was for me.
Oh.
Oh. Did you catch that?
What, he thought what?
This kid thought that was funny.
What?
Jesus.
The Jesus statue.
No, he didn't believe in any of that.
But it's funny you're saying that, because when I walked out there, I felt as though it were negative out there. Through that gate, I felt bad to go through there, so that's why I come back in.
That's why I came back in, because I didn't want to go through it.
Yeah.
And Heidi, I noticed as well, was a bit jumpy when you got there, weren't
you? Yeah, sure was,
And I bet you wanting to make him jump is like to take Mickey out of being in here.
Mm.
Would that make sense for how you're feeling?
Do you have a problem stepping into here? Can you not step into here? Or are you trying to draw us out to there, where we're a bit more vulnerable?
I'm very cold. I always go really hot.
Didn't it? Yeah. Last time we come, every door was shut in here.
Yeah,
I know that people come and go, but...
Did you guys know what's actually out there?
Not really. We didn't really go out there, did we?
That were all shut when we came last time.
Just a path, I think.
It's like a mini shortcut, like through a park.
I've just seen a flash of light down there.
Have you?
Yeah. Whether this car's going past, I
don't know. This car's debunked.
Debunked.
Yeah. You just got to bear in mind, that's the main road.
It just looked as though they were... closer than what they were, but they were definitely then cars,
Is there something?
Yeah,
there's
a bit.
Let's just shut him. Leave him out.
Shut the door now.
Yeah, leave him out there.
So, going back to when we stood over there, if we heard any footsteps, which I think we did hear, but it could have been anything, can you do that again now, please?
We were hearing that all the time, remember last time? Like crunching at leaves, weren't we?
Come and have a look at this. Come and touch that device if you want to.
Well, that can literally stay there most of the night, really, because nobody else is here and nobody's going to see that.
So. What we've got tonight as well, guys, is I've actually fetched a compass. Now, should the REM pod go off, I'll pull this compass out and we'll have a look and we'll see if the magnetic hand is actually spinning round, because it's believed that this is just as good as a REM pod. It's an alternative, but it can also prove that something's going on with that should this go off. So I'll keep this handy in my pocket, and it's just another aid for his investigation throughout this night.
Good idea, that.
Brilliant idea.
Probably just leaving that there.
So we'll leave that there, but we'll not hear that walk, will we?
We might do. I mean, they might be more invited to it if we go away from it. I'm going to see if Heidi's found who she's looking for.
So we're making our way now to the area where she felt drawn as soon as she came into this place.
How are you doing, Heidi?
All right, I'm good. I'm all right.
Are we, Oh, you felt? Did you feel like there's a caretaker or something?
Yeah, there's definitely a caretaker, and I just all it just keeps repeating it in my head.
Yeah.
And I thought there might have been something round, just to say who caretakers were, because some churches have like a list of who caretakers are.
Yeah. Did you say?
I'm just
brilliant.
Wondering if that mouse is something. Connect, because I felt when I said that, I come round and I said I feel like I'm looking for something, and I was looking at floor and everything. I saw this mouse, and I'm just wondering if that mouse is a connection to the last name or this Robert or whatever.
Okay,
no, mouse or something, I don't know.
This general area before, when me and Danny were here, we're getting some weird orb pictures. Now I've just took another picture, and there's a bright green one and a couple more in this general
area.
Yeah, so okay. I'll snap away. Now we are outside, and it could be pollen and things like that. But
yeah, there is.
It just looks out of place, this one.
Why don't we do it here?
We can do something here, can't we? This is where we actually did our electroscope experiment last time, and basically it's just a really old REM pod, the electroscope. Basically, you have two bits of foil inside the container with a copper antenna. Should have static charge it that. It opens and parts the foil, and you can visually see that that's been affected. Right, guys, so we're going to perform this first spirit box session of the night. As always, it's plugged into the amp. The spirit box is actually scanning at the moment. However, we're going to try it a bit different this time. When someone's going to ask a question, we will actually turn the spirit box down and then obviously turn it back up when we're looking for the reply. So, are we ready?
Yeah, we're ready.
Right, so we'll turn this up and we'll get this underway.
Hello, spirits. Can a spirit tell us what we've just seen around the back of the church?
Stopped. Could you tell us what animal we have just seen around the back of the church?
To 827's petition.
Mouse.
Can you say that again?
Nice and clear.
Right.
What's the name of this church?
I picked up on a name earlier. Can you say this name through Spirit Box, please, and validate it for me? Can you tell me what name I picked up on earlier and what connection it is, please? Switch it adjusted.
What name did Steve pick up on? What name's been coming into his head?
I've just seen something around the back of you.
Oh, back of me?
Yeah, I saw the legs.
Did you not see me look over there earlier? Because I saw someone move over there as well.
I just saw legs.
I've gone freezing. Quick, let me take a picture.
Come round.
That's your volume, first one.
And try and use the equipment.
Whoa.
Get that with me on.
Anybody else want to ask something before I say it back up?
So, this that me and Heidi's both seen running over here, who is that, please?
I heard that. It said he's called, yeah.
Do you not want to communicate with us tonight, spirits? We definitely know you're here. So if you can manipulate the words of this radio to talk to us and answer some questions.
Say the name of the person that you wish to communicate with.
So you're blocking everyone.
Who's in the dark?
Are you referring to the lights have gone out? Because we've literally been stood here and all the lights have gone out, but gone out on different times, so it's like a bit iffy if it's something to do with the timer, because actually that one's gone out first, and then after a while the one behind Danny's gone out and the church lights have gone out, so I wonder if they're referring to that we're stood in the dark. Is that right?
Is there a caretaker around here?
Can you turn them lights back on?
No.
Why not?
It's just police going through.
Is this Rob? Yeah. Or is this the caretaker?
I don't like being called Rob.
Sorry. Is this Robert? Do you know I've got that myself then?
What's up, Heidi?
My back's killing me.
It said back.
Is it yours, Heidi, or...? It's not yours.
Robert, do you find it easier to come through the AM frequencies than the FM?
Do you have a message for Robert?
Is Robert...
Sorry.
I was going to say, is Robert the caretaker? Did he I thought he said he's just called me Robert.
Are you affecting Heidi's back? Who's the spirit affecting Heidi's back? Steve.
Steven. Not me.
Is Robert connected to any of us in this group? If he is, can you say the name of that person clearly?
Jesus, we're revolt.
Jesus, we're revolt. Jesus, where he worked.
Now we are in a church, so.
What's the name of this church? Now for the guys at home.
Robert, a question.
Robert, could you answer that question for me, please? Where's that, sir?
Where are you?
Something about an app, then. Did you hear that? Something about an app. I don't know where you are, mate.
Are you happy? Are you at peace?
I was checking in before you could say no.
Do you need help?
I feel as though he needs to explain himself.
You feel like he needs to explain himself?
Yeah.
Was in what way he's done something wrong?
He just needs to explain himself. I don't know. Find out.
All right, Robert, we'll give you a chance now. Shall we give him a chance, see if he can explain?
Can you explain what you want to explain to someone through this device, please?
Trousers.
I was just having the same thought. I had that right mischievous thought of asking it to pull your trousers down. Team or souls in general?
I'm referring to others. That was a lady. Really?
That was a full sentence.
Yeah, it was.
I was referring to others.
Can you come forwards, dear? The woman who's just said that. Can you come forwards and speak to us? Is there something you want to tell us?
Are you trying to save somebody's soul?
Yeah.
I'm getting. I think there's. I think there's two people coming through here. I'm getting like mixed messages that aren't even making sense to the first one. This Robert, whatever this is to do with saving souls, it's not to do with him.
What do you want
to
do? Do you want to leave that there for now?
Yeah.
Try something a bit different.
Definitely, yeah. That was
put that down, never find.
I do, can I just say though, I do think when you put a spirit box through an amp, I do think it disorientates it a bit, muffles it a bit.
Yeah. We could try it.
It
yeah.
is hard to hear. Because of the
noise,
surrounding
we've had no choice,
area, we've got to do it.
Unless we're trying getting closer.
Yeah,
we do it
yeah we're getting closer.
I keep getting Dorothy, I have to give it up. Because yeah. I just keep getting Dorothy all the time.
Right, guys, we're coming up to the end of our investigation. It's absolutely freezing, so it's going to be a short one tonight. What we've set up here is analogue TV. Now, as you know, obviously analogue TV doesn't exist anymore. So in theory, we shouldn't get anything come through this device. What we've done is we've plugged the device into the amp so we can amplify the static sound that's coming through there. Ironically, we've placed this under the statue of Jesus. Everyone's been drawn to these statues tonight, so it's just possibly a trigger for us. We've heard it on the spirit box as well, so we'll just see what happens. We'll just turn it on. You know, we've caught voices on this before, so who knows what we might get here. So I'll turn this up now. It's already scanning. And what we're looking for really is any faces or sounds to come through this device.
If Robert's here, or anyone else that's communicated with us tonight, could you please make us aware and say something through this device, through this static? If you can't do that, try and show yourself on the screen of the device. Is there anything you can do at all?
If you would like us to leave, then do something to this device.
Try and harbour the energy that's coming from that device. Take it from the batteries if you need to, take it from the signal, take it from the camera, take it from ourselves.
Show yourself. I think something weird just happened when I was looking at the green line that was scanning down, actually disappeared half of it,
yeah.
Which I've never seen it do that before. It's going back now, it's been weird. It's like, I don't know, not seen it do that.
It seems really quiet now, isn't it?
Yeah.
What we're going to do, we're going to do another spirit box session. Because audio is a bit loud coming through that, and amp sometimes muffles it a bit, so we're going to do it without that. But Kyle's going to come in close, and I'm going to do it on AM still, because we seem to be getting responses then, so...
Do you believe that that's because the AM frequency is actually a lot older, and they might be more used to that, do you think?
Yeah, and I think it also stretches out further as well, right. AM frequency, obviously, than FM does.
Well, we did seem to hear a sentence, a full sentence from...
Same woman as well,
yeah.
Same
yeah.
voice, weren't it?
Well, I think there were two voices. I think one was a man's voice, which were quite clear,
Scottish,
and one was a woman's voice that were quite clear, so...
Yeah.
Let's see what we get. I'll scan forwards.
There we go. 10. Stop straight away.
Are you still here, Robert? Or is the lady still here?
Anything can happen. So you need to connect better?
I don't know.
That was a Scottish. That
yeah.
was Scottish.
And when they connect better.
Yeah, it were.
It's weird because we AM, you have to hold it at a certain angle.
Yeah, flat Steve on its side. Because the internal antenna's actually built inside it, isn't it?
I've always thought something like that, mate.
That's all right, there. Is Robert there?